The human body has an advanced neurological system in which the brain controls our sense of balance and orientation. For supercross riders, these systems are conditioned to the highest levels, but yet are very fragile.
Vestibular system is the part of your brain that integrates visual information but controls how we integrate space and motion. How my feet feel the ground, it's how my neck controls posture, it's how my head moves to find a target. It's me even going like that to find that target and being able to accurately stop and not way overshooting it and doing something like that. We take it for granted. Systems that you use more become more advanced or more refined. And when you translate that to sport, we're talking about a much more expansive, higher level of integration of that sensory information. The vestibular system in motocross athletes is only really comparable to hockey. I'm also a big proponent of believing that you should spend as much time training from the neck up as you do from the neck down. To me, that means doing hand-eye coordination drills to work on, you know, visual motor speed. It's doing movements that would mimic what I might do on a track. So if I'm looking up to go up a section and I'm looking down, maybe that's a piece that I need to work on so that my eyes find the target quicker. There's ways that we can look at how fast or how many times they can move their head even to a beat on a metronome. And so we know how much they're integrating visual information if we say, hey, focus on this target, and how many times can you process that while still keeping that target visibly clear or not blurry. We can also ask if we provoke symptoms, things like feeling foggy or slowed down. When you move your head, feeling as though your eyes don't catch up, it almost kind of feels like being a step behind yourself. And it's really pushed sports medicine, it's pushed neuropsychology to say, how can we identify ways to rehabilitate and get this system back to normal?